Dear friends, welcome to Rotating and Static Equipment channel. In this video session, we will discuss about an interesting shaft alignment application from the Android Google Play Store. The application name is Shaft Alignment Pro. You can get this application from Android Google Play Store. Just open Google Play Store and type Shaft Alignment Pro. Then you will get the Shaft Alignment Pro application. Unfortunately, it's not a free application. It's a premium paid application. You can buy this application for 350 rupees. Now we will go through this application. Shaft Alignment Pro is an Android application used in field to make easy the shaft alignment activities of rotating equipments. The application calculates the correction needed by adding shim or removing shim and moving the movable machine to align the equipment after 1 trading. This application can calculate the correction compared to the shaft alignment specification. So inside of this application, there are 5 shaft alignment techniques used. The first one is rim and face alignment. The second one is rim and double face alignment. The third one is laser calculator. The fourth one is reverse dial alignment 1. The last one is reverse dial alignment 2. The first one is for cross dial method. The second one is for opposite dial method. You can get the instruction manual book from the help option. Just go to the help. You can see the instruction and just follow the instructions. So now we will go to the rim and face alignment option. Just select dial rim and face 1. So first, shaft alignment specification. Here there are 2 options. The first one is mm, the second one is inches, that means miles. So I will select mm option. Then the shaft alignment specification is the reading shared by the equipment vendor, especially when a thermal growth is present. So you have to align the equipment to these values. Generally, the following equipment should align according to the alignment specification, like gas turbine, natural gas centrifugal compressor and the steam turbines. If you have any thermal growth readings or reference alignment reading, then you can enter the values from this shaft alignment specification. Otherwise, keep it as 0. Then click next. Next, we need to take some basic measurements. The first dimension is the diameter of the face dial indicator travel. Second, A dimension is the distance from the rim dial indicator to the front foot bolt center. And the third dimension is the distance between the dial indicator plunger center and rear foot bolt center. So these measurements are need to be measured accurately. So from the drawing, left side we have stationary machine and right side we have movable machine. So as per this application, so we need to fix the fixtures on the motor, that means movable machine, and we need to keep the dial on the stationary machine, that means fixed machine. Okay. So now I will enter sample readings. Then I click next. This is the reading data. Here we need to enter the rim and dial face indicators actual readings. If you find any Boussac values for rim dial and face dial, you can enter here. Otherwise, you can keep it as a 0. Then set the fixtures as shown in the figure and keep the both dials on the 12 o'clock positions. Set the rim dial 0 and set the face dial 0. Then rotate the both drivewind and non-drivewind shaft to 3 o'clock position. Record the reading on the both dials. Then rotate 6 o'clock position. Record the reading on both dials. Then rotate the shaft to 9 o'clock position. Record the reading on both dials, then rotate both shaft to the 12 o'clock position and ensure both dials returns to their original position at 0. Then fill all readings into the reading data. For example, then click next. Then you will get the correction needed to align your machine. top diagram is showing the vertical offset and angularity correction, and bottom diagram is showing the horizontal offset and angularity correction. For vertical plane correction, if the answer is plus means add shim. If the answer is minus means remove shim. For the horizontal plane correction, if the answer is plus means move the movable machine towards 3 o'clock position. If the answer is minus means move the movable machine towards 9 o'clock position. So as per the correction values, to correct the vertical misalignment, add 0.18 mm shim to the front foot and add 0.05 mm shim to back foot of the movable machine. To correct the horizontal misalignment, move the movable machine 0.08 mm towards 3 o'clock position to the both foots. Now both vertical and horizontal corrections are completed. Again, you can verify the reading data by determination of new set of readings. Then we will go for rim and double face alignment. Click dial rim and face 2. If you have any reference reading, you can enter here. Otherwise, keep it as 0. Just click to next. Then measure the required dimensions and enter here. For example, then click next. Now reading data. If you find any BOSAC values for rim phase 1 and phase 2 dial, you can enter here. Otherwise, you can keep it as 0. Then set the fixtures as shown in the figure. Keep the rim dial indicator and the phase dial indicator 1 in the 12 o'clock position and keep the phase 2 dial indicator in the 6 o'clock position. Set the all dials 0. Then rotate the shaft for 3 o'clock position, 6 o'clock position, 9 o'clock position and take the readings from the positions and enter into the reading data. For example, click next. Now you will get the correction needed to align your machine. For vertical plane correction, if the answer is plus means add shim, if the answer is minus means remove shim. For horizontal plane correction, if the answer is plus means move the movable machine towards 3 o'clock position, if the answer is minus means move the movable machine towards 9 o'clock position. Now Riemann double face alignment has been completed. Next we will go for laser calculator. Click laser calculator. If you have any reference laser reading, you can enter here. Otherwise, click next. If you are using a laser alignment kit and it's confusing to correct the misalignment, then you can use this option to correct the misalignment. Just measure this distance from the existing machines and enter here. For example, and then click next. Then enter the obtained readings from the existing laser alignment kit into the reading data. Click next. Now you will get the correction needed to align your machine. For vertical plane correction, if the answer is plus means add shim, if the answer is minus means remove shim. For horizontal plane correction, if the answer is plus means move the movable machine towards 3 o'clock position, if the answer is minus means move the movable machine towards 9 o'clock position. Next we will go for the reverse dial alignment 1. Just click dial reverse 1. For dial reverse 1 method, use two dial indicator, one for the radial in the movable machine and second for radial in the stationary machine, like a cross dial method. Then if you have a laser alignment reference reading, you can enter here. Otherwise, just click next. Mount the fixtures and the dial indicators as shown in the figure. Then measure the required dimensions and enter here. A dimension is the distance from the coupling center to the front foot bolt center. B dimension is the distance between the coupling center and the rear foot bolt center. C dimension is the distance between the stationary machine dial indicator and coupling center. D dimension is the distance between the stationary machine dial indicator and movable machine dial indicator. For example, now click next. If you find the BOSAC values for a stationary machine dial indicator and a movable machine dial indicator, you can enter here. Otherwise, leave it as 0. To obtain the dial indicating readings, rotate the dial indicator S to 6 o'clock position and M to 12 o'clock position as per the application drawing. Then set 0 on the both dial indicators. Rotate the dial indicators S to 9 o'clock position, M to 3 o'clock position. Then write down the dial indicator readings on both dials. Then rotate the dial indicators S to 12 o'clock position and M to 6 o'clock position. Then note the dial indicator readings. Then rotate the dial indicators S to 3 o'clock position and M to 9 o'clock position. Note the dial readings. Then again rotate the dial indicators S to 6 o'clock position and M to 9 o'clock position. And ensure both dials return to their original position as 0. Then fill the readings into the reading data. For example, then click next. Now you will get the correction needed to align your machine. For vertical plane correction, if the answer is plus means add shim, if the answer is minus means remove shim. For horizontal plane correction, if the answer is plus means move the movable machine towards 3 o'clock position, if the answer is minus means move the movable machine towards 9 o'clock position. Next we will go for dial reverse 2. Click dial reverse 2. For the dial reverse 2 method, use two dial indicators, one for radial in the movable machine and the second for radial in the stationary machines. The position of the indicators opposing one another on the opposite side, like opposite dial method. Then shaft alignment specification. If you have any laser alignment reference reading, you can enter here. Otherwise, click next. Mount the fixtures and the dial indicators as shown in the figure. Then measure the required dimensions and enter here. For example, then click next. Then the next reading data. If you find any BOSAC values for stationary machine dial indicator and a movable machine dial indicator, that you can enter here. Otherwise, keep it as 0. To obtain the dial indicator set of readings, rotate the dial indicators S and M to the 12 o'clock position and set 0 on the both dial indicators as per the application drawing. Then rotate the dial indicators to the 3 o'clock position and take the readings on the both dials. Then rotate the both dials on the 6 o'clock position and take the readings on the both dials. Then rotate the both dials to the 9 o'clock position and take the readings from the both dials. Then again rotate the both dials to the 12 o'clock position and ensure both dials returns to their original position as 0. Then fill the readings into the reading data. For example, then click next. Now you will get the correction needed to align your machine. For vertical plane correction, if the answer is plus means add shim, if the answer is minus means remove shim. For horizontal plane correction, if the answer is plus means move the movable machine towards 3 o'clock position, if the answer is minus means move the movable machine towards 9 o'clock position. You can correct the vertical misalignment as well as horizontal misalignment by using this application. I hope you all enjoyed this video session. Thanks for watching this video.